So, at the time that I got to play this game, which was like in late 2007, I think, yeah, it might have been early 2008. No, I think it was late 2007. At this time, really, Folklore was really the only JRPG worthwhile, it looked like, to play. Because the one JRPG that I really, really wanted to play at the time, which was Eternal Sonata, was a 360 exclusive. And I did not own that system. I still don't own that system, actually. But I mean, I have access to the system now because my roommate has a 360. But in any case, PS3 was the only current gen system I owned at the time, and I was really dying to play a Japanese RPG. Folklore was it. I mean, Sony of Japan published and pretty much made the title. It looked like a really unique game, I mean, judging just by its box art. And for the most part, I got what it promised. It's a very unique game. Even the gameplay is extremely unique. The graphics are vibrant, colorful, presents very unique environments, and what was I going to say? Oh, and the storytelling presentation is also very unique because it's presented like a stylistic comic book, with just fantastic art style. And you know, for the most part, the main theme I had with this game was I was really engrossed into it. I was really pulled in and compelled to play it for like the first few hours. And then it started kind of, you know, being like a chore to me. The game, I feel like, assumes that every gamer out there is patient. And it's a faulty assumption by the game, because gamers, in my opinion, really aren't patient. At least I wasn't patient enough for this game, and that's why eventually this game felt like too much trial and error and too repetitive. I ultimately wasn't able to finish the game. I believe I got to around chapter 6 before quitting. Unfortunately, I no longer own the copy. I wish I did, so maybe I can go back and kind of finish it or try to finish it. Because I think I could be compelled to play again. But the thing is, it does require a lot of patience. The way it tries to cut corners with this game design really has the gamer repeat things twice and do a lot of trial and error. But there is one really good reward to come out of this game, and that's really the story, which continued to pull me with this twist and with its incredible presentation of the game's universe. You know, it even the game's levels, it really started to portray what war, death, or hell could look like. It's a spirit universe, and it really shows you this afterlife universe, the spirit world. It's very morbid and dark, and yet at the same time, it's pretty vibrant and colorful. The way they mix that, those two totally contrasting themes together into one environment, a lot of different environments, it's just really, it shows. I gotta give kudos to the developers for that kind of design. The only thing is, I had to repeat each level twice with the different character each time. That's why it felt kind of repetitive eventually. Because I play a level, it's pretty amazing. I know I play first time with one character. It's like, all right, sweet, and I gotta repeat it with another character. Granted, the gameplay styles for the characters are a little different, but it's still largely very similar, and that's what I really wasn't patient enough for. So here's the gameplay mechanic that's gonna be at play. It really is like capturing different monsters. The spirit monsters in this game are called folks, which makes sense. That's why the game is called Folklore. And the thing that you do is you gotta capture these monsters, and once you do, you gain to have their special powers. So there is two characters, Ellen and Keats. If I remember their names correctly, Keats is the male character, Ellen is the female character. The male character, when they get the monster, he's able to have the monster kind of infused with him, and so he becomes part of the mon like if he captures like this big old monster, his arm will now be like Monster's Claw when he uses an attack. So he becomes infused with the monster, whereas Ellen is more of like, she's more like summons the monster. In either way, certain monsters are vulnerable to certain monster attacks. So you gotta kinda capture these monsters and figure out which monster is, which folk is vulnerable to which folk. And trying to figure that out is really the fun of it at first. It's unique and fun. And it also requires these six-axis motions to kind of pull the monsters out, you know? And there's different monsters require different methods of the six-axis motion. It's all very cool at first. I'm telling you. At first, everything in this game is just like, wow, it's so unique, so innovative. But eventually, it really gets repetitive. The only thing that really doesn't get repetitive are the boss fights. Boss fights are just freaking awesome. I didn't really mind too much that I had to beat each boss twice. Because, you know, I had to beat them as Ellen, and I had to beat them as Keats. They were still really fun. Boss fights is just really incredible. But trying to figure out which folk to use against which folk eventually got really more like super trial and error. I got stuck on that sixth level and haven't been able to get past it. And that's why I kind of quit. But yeah, that's really the premise of the game. The thing I would really recommend about this game are the environments, the levels. They look awesome. The folks have really creative design to them. The way you're able to capture each different folks, the way you have to figure out which folk to use against which folks, all that trial and error. But at first, it's really unique, really innovative. The storytelling is just cool. Even though they were working on a low budget, I guess. So a lot of the cutscenes are just still images or two character sprites with text dialogue. You know, the traditional Japanese RPG style storytelling. So very low budget game in that sense. But I didn't mind. I'm used to that shit. I'm not a graphics whore or anything. So I'm totally fine with that. The story really is what pulled me in. It's a very morbid theme, and it's exploration of themes like death, afterlife, war, death. Very morbid game when you're talking about just what kind of themes it focuses on. But at the same time, it's really engaging and interesting experience. It's just too bad I wasn't patient enough to complete it.